Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. Today is an exciting video. A lot of you have been asking me for an update on how things are going with clean eating on the WW program. So about a month into my transition, back in, I believe it was February, I filmed a video and gave you guys a 1 month update. Expectations versus reality. What do I think of clean eating? Is it working for me? Is it something that I want to continue? How do I feel about a lot of the aspects of the clean approach to WW? And what things have I noticed versus what things I expected that maybe weren't reality? So today I'm going to give you the same kind of video. We're going to talk about the expectations versus reality 6 months in to my clean approach to WW. We're going to talk about weight loss. We're going to talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly of clean eating on the WW program. A lot has changed for me, to be completely honest, over the last 6 months, and I can't wait to update you and share all of these exciting things with you. So if you want to hear a 6 month update on my clean transition to WW, stay tuned. With today's video, I just want to preface that I am not a registered dietitian, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nutritionist, and I'm not a healthcare professional. This is a recap, essentially an update on my personal journey following a clean approach to the WW program. Essentially, what this means is that I take a clean eating approach to Weight Watchers. 90-10 is the rule that I follow. 90% real whole food, 10% some of the things that I love that maybe don't fall in to the clean eating or whole food category. Example, my Built Bars. You guys know I love Built Bar. I continue to eat Built Bar, but they definitely aren't considered a clean food. So I'm going to go ahead and insert here the definition of clean eating. This is going to help kind of make sense to you guys what I mean by a clean approach to the WW program. I also have an entire playlist dedicated to clean eating 101 that I'm going to go ahead and link the playlist down below for you guys. I highly recommend that you check out all the clean eating videos that I've put out. If you're interested in possibly looking into this as the approach to the WW program for you. And definitely check out my 1 month update video so that you can kind of come full circle with me and see what happened 1 month in and what's happening currently 6 months in to this approach. So without further ado, let's talk about expectations versus realities, clean eating on WW. So the very first thing I addressed in my 1 month update video was my energy level. To this day, 6 months later, this is one of the biggest differences that I've noticed since my clean approach to the program. My energy is off the charts. Most days I have tons of energy. I'm able to do my daily tasks. I'm even able to get in a workout and still have energy to make dinner, clean the house, do the laundry, and spend time with my husband and Diesel and Lola. So that is still the reality for me. I'm loving the shift in my energy. When I was eating a lot of low fat, fat-free processed foods, I was dragging through the day, always hitting that mid-afternoon 3 o'clock slump where I wanted junk, crappy food, something sweet. That no longer happens for me. We're gonna talk more about snacking and things a little bit later in today's video. But my energy is still off the charts. It is honestly one of the top things that I love about clean eating, eating real whole food. It just satiates your body and it just gives you the energy that you need to make it through your day. In fact, there are even days, you guys, that I stay up past 8 p.m. And if you didn't know, that is my bedtime generally. I'm literally like a grandma. I get up at 4 or 5 in the morning. I go to bed at 8 p.m. And there are days that 8 p.m. comes and goes and I don't even blink an eye. I can stay up till 9, 10, that never happened before. So that increased energy is lasting throughout the entire day, which I'm absolutely loving and so incredibly thankful for. Next is sleep. And this is something else that I address. My sleeping is probably the second most favorite thing about clean eating. My sleeping is so much better. It's more sound. I'm not waking up during the night. I'm not waking up not feeling well. If you remember, I was always complaining about my stomach hurting before I transitioned over. My stomach always hurt, it kind of rumbled. In several of my weigh-in videos, I mentioned this. I couldn't figure out what it was that was causing me stomach distress. I have pinpointed it to being a lot of the fat-free, sugar-free, sugar alcohols, the things that I've eliminated from my diet, and now I no longer have stomach distress, which means I'm sleeping through the night, I'm waking up refreshed and energized and ready to go for the day. I don't even need something before bed to fall asleep and stay asleep. I used to have sleep gummies or melatonin. I don't even need that anymore. I fall asleep and I sleep soundly through the night, which is absolutely amazing, and it just really helps make for a more productive, energized day. So this next one may be TMI for some of you. So if you don't do well with TMI, skip ahead. So I talked in my video about being more regular. This is still absolutely 100% happening. I am the most regular that I have ever been in my entire life. It's like clockwork. It just happens. I feel good. And with being more regular, there are so many health benefits. I'm less bloated. My stomach isn't poochy and bloated because I'm not regular. I feel better. My body is doing what it should be doing. It's digesting my food. It's sending my food out, and it's working in the manner that it should be working. This is another area that I struggled with when I was eating the processed low-fat, fat-free food. And I'm so grateful to continue on the regular journey. I also discussed increase in my grocery bill. This was something that I expected with the transition over to clean eating, that I was going to be spending a lot more every week in groceries because I'm buying organic fruits and vegetables, grass-fed meats. I'm buying organic pasture-raised eggs and full-fat dairy and all the good food for you. And that reality is still what it was in the 1 month video. I don't find much of an increase at all in my grocery bill. I would say on average, what I'm spending every week is maybe $10 to $20 more by incorporating organic, grass-fed, pasture-raised. Because honestly, before the transition, I was still buying my Happy Eggs, my organic pasture-raised eggs. I still absolutely love those. I didn't buy as much organic produce, but to be completely honest with you, organic produce is literally pennies more than conventional produce. And that definitely does not play a part into the increase, the little increase in my grocery bill. It's more of the grass-fed meat, which you can still find fabulous prices on that. As you guys know, I buy my grass-fed, grass-finished ground beef from Walmart for $6.48 a pound, which is literally 48 cents a pound more than regular conventional ground beef that is not grass-fed, that's fed a GMO corn, a GMO feed, not as good for you. So for me, 50 cents is absolutely nothing. So I'm still feeling really confident in my grocery budget, staying where it needs to be, even though I am incorporating these healthier alternatives to some of those maybe not healthy foods that I bought before. And that kind of leads me into this next one, and that is I feel much more satisfied and satiated. I mentioned this in my 1 month update. That is still the case today. With the grocery bill, this is something that I want to make sure that I address. Because I'm more full and satiated with my meals, my breakfast, my lunch, my dinner, I find myself snacking a lot less. I very rarely, very, very rarely have a morning snack. So I have breakfast, and what I'm eating sustains me to lunch. Prior to clean eating, I always had a morning snack. So I'm having to buy that morning snack. And now that's eliminated from my grocery budget. It's eliminated from my points and my calories for the day. And I'm able to skip that morning snack and move right into lunch. I do often have an afternoon snack just because the span between lunch and dinner is longer. And I generally have a workout in there as well. So I'm needing that little bit of extra fuel. But because I'm not snacking as much and I'm not buying as many snacky foods, my grocery budget didn't take the hit for the organic and the grass-fed and the pasture-raised. And I'm fueling my body with good quality food, and I'm not really spending very much more at the grocery store, and I'm full and I'm satiated and I'm satisfied 100%. Another expectation I had was trying to stay within my points, knowing that real whole food costs more points. Full fat dairy, full fat nut butters, those cost more points than low fat and reduced fat versions. I try to eat full fat cheese. If anything, I have light cheese, but all of my dairy is generally full fat, including my milk. I really focus on nut butters and nuts for snacks, which are much higher in points than choosing a processed snack like a Fiber One bar or a granola bar. You're going to be spending a lot less points in those, but you're just not getting the nutrient benefits that you're getting with nuts and seeds and that type of thing. So I was worried about staying within my points. At the 1 month mark, I wasn't finding that a lot. I mean, it was there, it was kind of lingering. I was struggling a little bit to stay within my points, like I mentioned, but now as time has went on and I've really gotten into my own when it comes to my clean eating on WW, staying within my points is definitely a struggle. So that expectation is a reality now. I struggle every day to stay within my points and to reach my caloric goal. You also know that I've really been talking about calories versus points. I have several videos on that. I'm gonna link those down below for you guys, where I'm talking about eating all my points in a day and not being anywhere near my calorie goal to keep my metabolism revving and my body being a fat burning, weight losing machine. So for me, I've had to put staying within my points to the side and really focus on calories. I still track my points every day because there are days that I stay well within my smart points, but I like to be able to see the data of points versus calories. I have been making a transition into really, really focusing on calories and double tracking points. So calories have kind of been put at the forefront and points kind of on the back burner. Now, like I said, I'm still doing both. I'm still following the blue plan on WW, but I'm trying to gain data and gain knowledge when it comes to points versus calories when you're eating a lot more whole real food. So stay tuned for a lot more coming on that topic. I also worried about finding real organic whole food that actually tastes good, because all of those processed foods, those chips, those cookies, those snacks, they actually taste really, really good. And I was really unsure if I was going to be able to find a clean food, snacky foods that taste good. And I've been more than pleasantly surprised. You guys know what my favorite clean eating foods are. I did an entire video on my favorite snacks. I'm gonna link all those down below for you guys as well. But that has not been a struggle at all, especially since I found the Thrive Market. So the Thrive Market is an online market. They sell real whole food. They even sell everything from pets, laundry, home care, baby care. It's really like it's a big supermarket online, but they really have a focus on real, whole, delicious, organic, good for you food. And their prices are about 30% less than your traditional natural food or your grocery store. So I've been loving Thrive. I've been buying a lot on Thrive. I found some really great, amazing products to substitute some of those not so good for you products that I ate before. I highly recommend Thrive. Down in the description box is a link for $20 worth of free product of your choice when you join Thrive for their yearly membership. Highly recommend you guys, it ships for free. They usually throw freebies and goodies into your box. Thrive is amazing. And ever since I found Thrive, which was right about that 1 month mark, I've utilized that at least 1 to 2 times a month to get my staples. I also talked about points versus calories way back in February when I filmed that video, in March when I uploaded it, we were talking points and calories back then. It's just really become more of a focus for me. I really wanted to make sure that I wasn't doing damage to my metabolism by eating these whole foods that cost more points but aren't any more calorie dense than the processed foods. I wanted to make sure that I was reaching that calorie goal. And it's kind of become an obsession. It's kind of become my baby, like it's close to my heart. And every day I want to make sure that I'm reaching that calorie goal, but I'm backing that data up with how many points I'm spending every day. And it's been quite interesting. I'm actually going to be filming a what I eat in a week, calories versus points. That should be out shortly after this video, so definitely stay tuned for that. It may even be out before this video, but we're gonna really deep dive into calories versus points and making sure that we're doing what's best for our body. So that is still something that is a reality for me. It's just become a little bit more, or a lot more, in the forefront of what I'm doing on my healthy eating journey. And last but not least, let's talk about my weight loss since my starting my approach to clean eating. So when I uploaded my 1 month video in March, at that point I had lost just under 10 pounds since the beginning of the year. Now, since March up to the current time, I've lost a total of 17 pounds. April was a struggle. I lost 1 pound in the month of April, but other than April, I've been losing anywhere from 3 to 6 pounds a month, which is perfect for me. I'm keeping my metabolism going. I'm keeping my body a fat burning weight loss machine, but I'm not doing damage to my metabolism by eating enough calories. So that is exactly what I want to do. So I am happy that I'm continuing to lose weight. In fact, since transitioning to clean eating, I've lost more weight on average every week than I ever did prior to that switch to that approach. So I'm internally grateful for that. It's going really, really well. I very rarely gain in a week. Most of my weeks result in some sort of a loss or a maintain, and I am so happy with that. Even through the whole virus, I was able to lose weight every single month, which is amazing. So I credit a lot of that to the foods that I'm eating, as well as being mindful of my calories versus my smart point. So I'm thrilled with clean eating, so happy that I made this change. Now, I know a lot of you are really interested in taking a cleaner approach to WW, and I encourage you to do so, but I also want to remind you to do that in baby steps. You don't have to go all out. You don't have to get rid of all the processed food in your house and spend thousands of dollars or hundreds of dollars bringing in clean food. Just as you run out of something that isn't considered clean or a food or has an ingredient that you no longer want to eat, phase that out and bring in something that's a little bit cleaner. Get rid of your non-organic produce and buy organic produce if that's what you choose to do. But what I love about WW is there are several programs for us or plans for us to choose, because not everybody is different. Everybody has a different approach to weight loss and their healthy journey. This is the approach that I've taken, which doesn't mean that this has to be the approach that you're taking. We all need to work the program the way that works for us. I'm just here to share my journey with you. You guys ask me a ton of questions. I try to help answer those when it comes to clean eating. Is this clean? Is that clean? Would you eat this? Would you eat that? I've shared a ton of new clean eating finds with you guys. Lots of great protein powders, the Thrive Market. So I'm here to share my journey with you. And of course, you again, work the program the way that it works for you. No one is saying that processed, fat-free, sugar-free foods are bad. No food is bad. What I'm saying is that for me, I'm choosing just a different approach to the program. So I hope that that makes sense. I do sometimes get comments or negative feedback about feeling like I'm food shaming, and that's not the case at all. I'm just simply saying what foods I choose not to eat, not that any food is bad. And let me tell you, I still eat junky food every once in a while. That's where the 90-10 comes into play. And again, that's how I've chosen to work the program. So thank you so much for being here for a 6-month update on my clean approach to WW. If you're new to my channel, I'd love for you to stick around, join my YouTube friends and family. It's a pretty fun place to be. Make sure you hit that little subscribe button and that bell so you're notified whenever new videos are uploaded. If you love these clean eating updates and this clean eating series, give this video a big thumbs up. It really helps out my channel, and I really, really appreciate it. Please, any questions, comments you have, leave them down in the comments. I love hearing from you guys. And I want to say thank you for your support of my channel, for being my best friends here on YouTube, and again, for watching today's video. Thank you guys, and I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.